Hey, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja and Basement Ninja, and today I'm going to discuss with you what I feel you need to know before insulating your attic. Insulating your attic will improve air quality, it will improve efficiency, and also make your house more comfortable. So you want to make sure you do it right. Stay tuned. Okay, first of all, this is staggering. Did you know that the Department of Energy says that a properly insulated attic could improve or save you between 10 to 50% of your heating bills every year? Is that not nuts? That means that most people have a very, very uninsulated attic. And we've seen this time and time again. We'll go into an attic and there'll be that much insulation and, you know, they're walking around in hoodies and all that kind of stuff. So what we want to do is we want to give you some tips that you should think about before even insulating the attic, and also explain to you some of the different methodologies in insulating your attic. Number one, make sure that if you're going to go through all the expense of insulating your attic, air seal all the major penetrations in the attic floor. This is all of the heating and air duct penetrations, all of the exhaust vent fan penetrations. If you've got a water heater, then it's got, you know, the piping going up through the attic. You're going to need to get some fireproof caulk and build a dam around that to make sure that the insulation doesn't burn. You wanna make sure all that is done properly. You wanna make sure that you're air sealing all of those chases and your attic hatches and all of that stuff. And if you've got one of those big monster fans that's in your hallway that they installed back in the 70s and 80s to ventilate the house, I recommend you just yank that dude out and seal all that guy up and air seal it properly and redo that drywall. And that should take care of most of the air loss from your living space up into your attic. Okay, so this should go without saying, but obviously you want to make sure that you take care of all roof leaks. Now, believe it or not, not everybody thinks about that. If you get up there and you see matted insulation or insulation that maybe looks like it might have debris or different things like that, you could be getting water from the roof leaking or from your gable vent. Okay, whenever we did our attic, we had two gables, obviously. It was a shotgun style attic. So you had two gables, okay? Well, one side, one gable was taking on all this blowing rain. So when we got up there to suck out all that old insulation so that we could air seal the floor of the attic, we discovered there was mold all over the drywall. It was a great place for snakes to get in and different things like that. So you want to make sure you air seal those gables if you find out that they're letting water come in, because you don't want to blow in insulation or put batting down or whatever down there only for that insulation to get wet and ruined in the future. Another big mistake that we see people not doing, as a matter of fact, we've had quite a few people call us that they have developed a mold problem after they hired a contractor to blow in insulation because they didn't make sure the attic was properly ventilated. Okay, so there's two types of ventilation. There's active and passive. Active ventilation would be installing solar attic fans or some kind of active ventilation that comes on when the temperature gets to a certain point. Passive ventilation is where you have maybe the gable and, I'm sorry, the soffit and the ridge vent. So that way, during the convection process, when the attic gets really hot, it starts to move air from the soffit up through the ridge vent. The only problem is they didn't put baffles in to make sure that those soffits didn't get clogged. So if you're gonna pay somebody to put batting insulation in your attic or blow in insulation, if they don't have those soffit vents open for airflow, it could create a mold problem. So make sure you invest in that as well. Okay, another big mistake we see people doing is that they will have all this plywood down so that they can store their Christmas trees and old photos and things up in their attic. Well, guess what? If you've got plywood directly on a piece of 2x4, you've only got about 3 inches of insulation if they even insulated underneath the plywood at all. So get all that plywood out of there and stop using your attic for storage. If you're concerned about comfort and energy loss and all that kind of thing, try to find another place to put those items. And I know that's a big expense, But anyway, that could hinder the amount of insulation you're able to install because of all of the plywood that you've got for storage. Okay, so we've got two different types of insulation. We've got Batt insulation, and which is the rollout insulation, and then we've also got loose fill insulation. Most of the time, contractors will install loose fill insulation. It tends to do better in lower attics where you have more obstacles to work around and all that, because you can just blow it around that that stuff. Now, the Batt insulation tends to be more of a DIY project because it's easier to utilize and manage, and you don't have to rent a machine. You can just buy the batting insulation and throw it up. So I want to talk about three different types of loose fill. The one we personally like the best is the fiberglass, okay? Because it's naturally fire retardant. It tends to be about the same in cost. The R value is about an R2 per inch. So, you know, it's really good. It's clean. It blows in clean. It tends to be less dusty. Than some of the cellulose and rock wool items that we've seen. But the advantage of rock wool is that it has a chemical treatment that can you know, cause pests not to want to nest in it and things like that. So a lot of your pest control companies will blow in only rock wool. That's all they use. I'm sorry, only cellulose. They only blow in cellulose. That's the only kind of insulation they'll use, because a lot of people will call pest control companies to do the insulation after they've had a raccoon infestment or mice or rats or things like that. Obviously, you don't want to have a litter box over your house. So one of the things you can do if you're going to use either cellulose or fiberglass is make sure you seal all of those penetrations around the attic to keep pests and different things from climbing in. It's called exclusion. So you can create an exclusion zone all around the attic to stop that. The last one that we come across very little in our area is rock wool. Okay, so from what I understand about rock wool is it tends to be more expensive than the other two, and it's just harder to get a hold of in certain areas. So typically most people in our area is going to use either loose fill fiberglass or cellulose. And as I mentioned before, fiberglass is our number one choice. Now, if you're going to use a Batt style insulation, then you've got four choices. You still have fiberglass, you still have cellulose, you still have rock wool, but they've also got some cotton fiber insulations out there. So if you're going to tackle this project on your own, a little bit at a time, then you may decide that using a Batt insulation is easier for you to work with, and you don't have to rent a machine, especially if you're just doing this a little bit at a time. You know, most of the time getting those machines for a few hours can be costly and all that, even though it tends to go faster. But remember, don't do any of that insulation until you've air sealed the floor of the attic. You don't want to take all that time and blow in, you know, R38 or R49 of insulation and then have to suck it all out because you've realized that you made a mistake. So make sure that you're air sealing first. The other thing you want to do is if you're in a really cold climate, you need to have at least an R49, okay? And then if you're in a warmer climate, you can get away with less. In a temperate climate, like maybe Tennessee, you want to go with at least an R38. So that's about 12, 13 inches of insulation would be R38. So the colder, if you're up in Minnesota, you want to go a lot thicker. If you're down in Florida, you don't have to go quite as thick, but air sealing is still just as important no matter what your climate is to stop drafting and all that sort of thing. Okay, so as I mentioned before, you may want to get rid of bad insulation. If you've had rain come in through the gables or you've had some kind of roof leak or something like that, make sure you get yourself an insulation vacuum and suck out all of that bad stuff. And the bad thing about wet insulation is, number one, it's not really that effective, but number two, it's kind of hard to get out. It's really tough. It can cake up and all that sort of thing. So make sure that if you've got a lot of caked up insulation up there, especially that cellulose, I mean, can you imagine wet paper? How difficult is that to get out of an attic? So if you're gonna take the time, don't just blow good insulation on top of bad insulation. Make sure you invest and get all of that bad insulation out and then air seal the attic. And lastly, if you live in a part of the country that offers energy credits, either through your local municipality, your power, or things like that. TVA used to do stuff like that. They don't really do it anymore. But if you're in some of those high energy states, like probably California, over on the West Coast, up in Washington, Oregon, even up in New England, they may have energy credits that can help you get a bonus or a rebate on that insulation that you install. So my name is Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja. I hope this was helpful for you. Before you tackle that attic insulation, make sure you take a look at all those steps, and I hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.
The Christmas lights fill the city. There are people everywhere. The snow is falling white and pretty. As I